Today, we will start with a new chapter with lesson number one, Socio-Religious Reform of semester two. Now, in this chapter, we will go through what type of Indian society was and which are the social evil customs which were there prevalent in our society and what type of reformation work took place by number of reformers and their contribution. So let's begin with the explanation. In the 19th century, Indian society was infested. Infested means was present with various social evils like superstition, illiteracy, ignorance, evil social customs, caste system, etc. The condition of women was worst in this narrow-minded society. Why the condition of the women were worst? Because there were so many customs, culture, which was there prevalent in our society, which because of that reason, the condition of women was worst. With some of the examples like Doodh Peeti means female infanticide by immersing a newborn girl child into a container full of milk. Here you can see the container which is full of milk. And here a newborn girl child was being dipped into this container which was full of milk where they were being killed. Second is the sati system. Sati system means the burning of a woman on her husband's funeral pyre. So here a live lady is being burned on the funeral of her husband. Next is denial of widow remarriage. So here the widow were not being allowed to marry again. Due to the Western education, a new awakening, or you can say renaissance, began in the 19th century. To remove the evil customs from the society, intensive efforts were being made to bring a social and religious reform. And first of all, we will move on with the number of reformers. First, we will talk about Raja Ram Mohan Roy, who was the first among such reformer. Raja Ram Mohan Roy was born in the year 1772 CE in the Hooghly district of Bengal in Radhanagar village in a Brahmin family. Raja Ram Mohan Roy got married in his early childhood. His brother's wife became Sati on her husband's death. This incident shook Raja Ram Mohan Roy deeply because this incident he saw in front of his eyes and in his home. So he was very much affected from this Sati Pratha and all. He initiated this incident shook Raja Ram Mohan Roy deeply. He initiated many reforms and protested strongly against the evil customs such as child marriage, casteism, Doodh Peeti, etc. He started Bengali newspaper, namely Samvad Kaumudi, in the year 1821 CE, and also Mirat ul Akbar in Persian in the year 1822 CE. Brahmo Samaj was established in the year 1828 CE. Raja Ram Mohan Roy established the Hindu College in Kolkata. He recommended many changes to the British government like the independence of press, freedom of speech, women's right, personal liberty, judiciary, independence from executives, etc. Raja Ram Mohan Roy started the movement to abolish the Sati system. As a result, British Governor General of Bengal, Lord William Bentinck, passed a law to abolish the Sati Pratha, and this is how the whole Pratha was stopped. This law was framed in the year 1829 CE. So it can be said that the Raja Ram Mohan Roy laid the foundation of the Indian Renaissance, or the new awakening started with the initiative which was being taken by Raja Ram Mohan Roy. With regard to initiating social, religious and political reforms, the Emperor of Delhi sent Raja Ram Mohan Roy to England in the year 1830 CE in regard to his case in the right to property. Raja Ram Mohan Roy died in Bristol in the year 1833 CE. Brahmo Samaj played a vital role in reforming the contemporary Hindu Samaj. Brahmo Samaj tried to abolish the rigid and superstitious religious belief prevalent then. We will continue with Dayanand Saraswati. Dayanand Saraswati was born in a Brahmin family in Tankara village near Morbi in Saurashtra. In his early childhood, he realized that the idol worshipping and religious rituals were worthless. He renounced his family. Renounce means he gave up his family and the world in search of truth. He traveled across India for the next 15 years and also studied yoga. He became sannyasi and he studied the philosophy of Hinduism from Swami Vrajanand Dandesha in Mathura. Swami Dayanand Saraswati made an attempt to achieve national unity by advocating a classless and casteless society, because he believed that a country or a nation can grow when there is no class or caste. He acquired a deep insight into the Indian culture and religion through the Vedas. He studied the Vedas thoroughly. He preached the people to go back to the Vedas. Why? Because he wrote a book entitled Satyarth Prakash. He made people aware that in the Vedas, there is no mention about the evil customs such as idol worship, rituals, child marriage, sati pratha, untouchability, etc. Because in the Vedas, these are the number of things, evil customs are not being mentioned. He advocated monotheism, that is, there is only one God. He preached in Hindi, and as a result, his thoughts reached the maximum number of people in the country. So as the communication, his language was Hindi, so he was able to communicate a large number of people. Dayanand Saraswati established the Arya Samaj in 1875, and branches of which were established in Lahore, Punjab, Uttar Pradesh, Rajasthan, and Gujarat. So these are the number of places where Arya Samaj were established. Consequently, social changes occurred rapidly. Arya Samaj started a movement to reconvert those people to Hinduism who have changed their religion out of force or choice and were willing to return to their original faith. So he also encouraged those people, those who again wanted to come back to their religion. After the death of Swami Dayanand Saraswati, the activities of this organization were continued by leaders like Lala Hansraj, Pandit Gurudat, and Lala Lajpat Rai. So these are the number of leaders who continued the activities which was started by Dayanand Saraswati. In the year 1902 CE, Kangri Gurukul was established near Haridwar by Swami Shraddhanand. Arya Kanya Mahavidyalaya was started in Vadodara, Gujarat, where the education focused on inculcating discipline, dignity of labor, tolerance, patience, and moral values. So not only the education, but these are the number of activities, things were also inculcated among the young children. Now, the another reformer we will be talking about is Ramakrishna Paramhans. Ramakrishna Paramhans was the torchbearer of the Indian culture. Now, he is also considered as one of the torchbearer, means a leader who inspires others towards a goal. So he was also a reformer. Reformer means a person who works to make some changes in the society which are existing. And he had sought the truth through all the religion. He was born in Kamarpukur village of Hooghly district in Bengal. He took interest in the religious activities from his childhood. He became a priest in the Kali temple of Dakshineshwar near Kolkata. Many of the people were attracted towards him due to his preaching on purity of character and deep knowledge. So many of the people who used to listen to him were attracted towards his preaching, because his preaching were more of on having a good character and he was having a deep knowledge. He tried to attain God in various forms. Many religious reformers like Keshav Chandra Sen, Dayanand Saraswati and other had obtained guidance from him. So he was like guru to these men, number of people who used to give proper guidance. Those influenced by the Western culture redeveloped their faith in culture and religion of India because of the preaching of Ramakrishna Paramhans. And many of the people, those who were attracted towards the Western culture, also redeveloped their interest towards their own culture, Indian culture and religion. And they, why? Because of the preaching of Ramakrishna Paramhans. Here I end up with this video.